Hi and welcome to CG High Dog, your shortcut to mastering digital creation. In today's tutorial, I will be showing you how to texture assets in the style of Overwatch. We will be using Genji's Shuriken as an example, and I will guide you through the entire process step by step. So, and with this, we are going to start with the fill layer and assign base values to reset all the channels which will be used. That looks like this. So I used black for the base color, roughness is 1, metallic is 0, and the MSF is black. Then I assigned base values to the channels itself. This is our metallic. This is our base color, roughness, and MSF, which doesn't contain any color information yet. So the next step is I'm going to focus on the base color, and we start with the blade. And here I use the blue channel, or maybe the blue channel of the word space normal, which you can bake in Substance Painter, which looks like this if you assign it to your mesh. But also it depends on the orientation of your asset. Then use levels to extract or like adjust the values that I need, and use the blur on top. And this is my directional lighting, or the lighting information, which you can also color or tint. But we will go with the dirty white color here, not purely white. Then I added some gradients on the blade. Did a quick color pass to make it more interesting and having like a gradient like thing going on. And now I added some soft dirt, which is just noise, on top of the surface, and blurred it, and used the color selection to deselect the blade or the edge, and also use some color information in the dirt itself, which I can highly recommend to use a little bit more color. So don't go like with purely white or purely black. Have some color information that makes your asset more interesting. Then I did the same thing for the hard dirt. I hand painted everything, then used warp and blur to give it a more like jaggy lines, and also used a little bit like bluish, dark bluish color accent. Now let's move on to scratches. That's also simple. I hand painted everything, use blur and warp to get rid of the straight lines. And here also I use the lighter blue, white bluish, to have a metal like color. And for the end, I used my curvature map that is also baked in Substance. Use levels to have my edge information. Use some contrast luminosity and blurred it to have a soft highlight on the blade. So that's our blade part. I did kind of the same thing for the metal. So we're going to start with the direction lighting. Here I use the green channel, which looks like this. Use levels to adjust it and to get the information I want, and blurt it to make it more soft. So that would be our direction lighting for the metal part. Then I use some gradients with color, which goes from the middle to to the outwards. And also some information on the blade, but which shouldn't apply. Then I use some more surface information for the metal. I used just the oil texture, which I used the value mode, blend mode, with a small value for the opacity. Then the same thing here with the soft dirt. Hand painted everything and blurred it at the end. Then I got strokes. So it's just a tileable stylized texture and some hot dirt. So, and there are no scratches. It's empty. And that's the final step. Same thing again. Curvature, levels, contrast, blur, and some hand paint. So with this, you can just like hand paint yourself some areas, or like get rid of it if you use the multiply as the blending mode. And this gives us with this highlights. So now we can move on to the post. Here I increased the shading, or added more shading information, which is highlights, but more sharper than before. And this applies overall on the whole mesh. So here I use the curvature again, levels, blur, and I think I painted some areas away, yeah. This part. Which gives us this kind of shading. Then I kind of did the same thing, but just for the cavities. So I got my curvature inverted, used levels to extract the data I need, and blurred it a little bit, and give it a rusty color. And here I used overall AO. Also hand painted some areas, or decreased the intensity. Here I also added the ambient occlusion to the ambient occlusion channel. And here we got our gradient for the blade. Which starts from the middle and goes outwards. So it's really important to use gradients. They are really important for stylized asset creations, or like texturing. Also here, you can see, I also use it for the ring part. Then I did some hand painting or paint over for the blade to make it more intense. Also used an AO for the emissive and roughness part. Also here the same thing for the roughness, so that the area where the AO is, that's more rougher. And for the end, I just adjusted the ring light and made it more intense, and also give it a three-dimensional shading. Here I used the wet space green. Levels, blur, and then use overlay for the blending mode. And that's all. That's how you texture an asset like in the style of Overwatch.